Hello friends, and a very hearty where's my claymore to all of you in the chat today. Welcome back to Redly Deadly Redemption 2 with me, Andy. It's a beautiful Saint-Denis morning. The mist rolling in off the bayou. The folks are out and about. The god rays are coming in, being rendered by ray tracing probably, I expect. And we're ready for some more cool Red Dead Redemption missions. We're gonna do some just a chill stream today. We're not gonna do too much. We got some missions to take care of. If we look at the map, see what we got. We've got to do something for Rain's Fall. We've got to do something for Mary Beth. Yeah. So you know, just a nice. It's been quite a few weeks. It's been quite busy, quite stressful. So I'm just gonna relax with a bit of Red Dead Redemption 2. Thanks for joining me, everyone. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a good Monday so far. Tom Titherington says, sending some love to everyone. Thanks, Tom. Sending some love back. Thanks for joining me. But before we start, as always, we need to choose what we're going to wear, because we're still wearing our date outfit from when we went on that date. It's a good date outfit, but probably not for the kind of intimidating cowboy stuff that we're going to be doing today. So let's just let's go in and pick some fashion.
Now what's going on in here?
What's going on in here, indeed? So we're going to just change real quick out of what we've got so far. Baseline brawler outfit. Pretty straightforward. So yeah, I think we're going to be doing some kind of tough guy intimidation stuff, but we're in Saint-Denis as well, which is kind of a fancy town, you know. Can't be dressed poorly in Saint-Denis. So why is that there? Why are you here? All right. Might have to ignore that. Or I can just not draw attention to it. That's probably a better idea, isn't it? All right. Do I still have that... let me just change my shirt. I want to see if I've still got that cool scarf that I got last mission when we went on the riverboat robbery, because that was great. So let me hit up the wardrobe real quick and see if we've got that. Because that is the sort of hero piece that we can build an outfit around. So let's have a look. Need to have the right shirt on, though. You see, it's all layers. It's layer upon layer. Really is the most important part of Red Dead Redemption. Yeah, so we still have the ascot. That's good. So I'm thinking we build an outfit around this ascot tie. What do you say, folks? I agree with Andy. Yeah, that's... I agree with... Yeah. All right. People say us tailors all sound the same. It's annoying that that's doing that. I'll just no one look at it, all right? No one look at it and it'll be fine. Now, let me have a look. So, the ascot is blue. So let's build something around that. Around the colour blue. What have we got in a Parisian? You see, that's nice. That is a local favorite. I like that. But also, maybe the paisley. No, it's too much. There aren't any blues in that. And the opulent, I think, is a bit too... Yeah, that's not going to work for me. All right. Parisian... Okay. In the blue, looking good. Now, what have we got? What have we got pants-wise that will go with this? If there was just a light, yeah, is that grey or blue? Kind of blue. Let's put that on. So, what do you think? And then wearing it out. Get the boots on, as always. And the chaps to go with it. If there were blue leather gloves, that would be amazing. There aren't, so go the slightly lighter one though. No one can see these, but that's fine. A bit of blue in the chaps, maybe. Not really. Yeah, that's fine. A bit lighter. There we go.
Sure.
Right. Coat. What is this Claymore stuff that people are talking about? Please explain. Because I didn't get to catch Luke's live stream. So please explain to me what happened with a Claymore. All right, we've got some new members. Ryan M. is a new member. And SS says, hi from Brooklyn. Wanted to say thank you and the entire team for all your hard work in 2020. You all kept me company through my own COVID while alone, far from family, amongst other things. Love you all. I'm sorry to hear you had COVID. Hope it's all good now. And yeah, happy we could be of some small help. Is that blue?
What is your preferred color?
Sort of blue,
this?
Isn't it? But maybe blue isn't what we want. No, not a duster coat. No, come on. Be serious. Nope, hate it. Okay. Might go with black from the wardrobe, to be honest.
Just for those.
Or... is that too... Is that too much mixing style there, do you think? What do you think, chat? Too much casual and smart? Overlapping? I don't know. Queen Wren is a new member. April Robinson says, I'm sorry to hear you've been stressed, Andy. Hopefully this can buy you a cup of tea. Oh, thanks. I'm not that stressed. It's just a lot of work at the moment with the new consoles and stuff. I've been playing a lot of Yakuza, Like a Dragon. I'm waiting for this to come, for the chat to come through, so people can tell me what they think about this combination. Bit clashy.
Quality.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Let's try it with a hat and see if that changes the vibe. Because it might do.
Every hat style
I think the ascot might be a bit fussy for this jacket.
Respect.
Even with a great hat. Yeah. All right. The coat is good. But I think it might be a bit clashy with the ascot, which I am. I did commit to building the outfit around. So let's see what else I've got in the wardrobe, coat-wise. You see, that doesn't really go, does it? Because of the red. Oh, this is a disaster. No. Why would I wear no? Ah, the black and the silver, though. Kind of digging that. And then, hat-wise, what have we got? No, I don't think so. That is not blue. Don't know why you would claim otherwise. What's the difference between that and the stalker hat? Oh, I see. It's got a sort of curled brim. Yeah, I do prefer that. Yeah, all right. Okay. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. Let's head out. All right, looking good, I think.
I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence.
See how you folks are doing in the chat. Gentle Mandrill says, sending some money for the amazing stream starting soon screens you always prepare for us. Thanks for putting so much work into Morgan Mondays. I feel like I haven't been able to put as much work into it as I would like recently. Haven't had a new song for a little while. I kind of want to get to Guama because I think a sort of song about Guama. I think that would be fun. So yeah, let's see how we do today. Tyce says we seem to have misplaced our claymores.
Oh,
poor Luke. Always losing his claymore. Bob says, excited for some Red Dead Redemption 2. Weird question, what's the one thing you have on your person at any given time? I always have a lighter with me, not sure why. For lighting things, I would guess. I don't know if there's anything, apart from like, my, oh god, ran someone down. Pay attention. No one saw it. No one saw me. Yeah, apart from like my phone and my wallet and my keys. And these days, my mask. Yeah, I don't know if there's anything else I have on me at all times. I've got a, still in my wallet, I've got a, like a Disneyland pass. Disney World, the Florida one, in my wallet. Because it's got the Haunted Mansion on it, and I can look at it and remember that cool holiday I had to Disney World. But apart from that, yeah, not really.
Can I say something rude?
Chicken Parmesan says, you should go red since you're wearing red, and the first word of the game title is red, and you'll stand out against all the muted earth tones of the game world. Good morning, looking forward to this. Well, we've gone blue, but maybe later on we can change.
Do you,
all right, we've got to find out what's going on here.
Can you?
Can I steal? Yeah, I mean, I can steal things. I'm a career criminal.
Incriminate myself, Mr. Miller.
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met?
Don't like this guy, Simon.
This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, yeah, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls.
It's just Brianna as a new member. Thank you for joining.
You have great powers of observation. As my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties. And those treaties were broken. And we've been moved and punished. And
yeah, these guys have had a rough deal. So,
sure.
Being the world's nicest person, being 1899's nicest, most tolerant person,
this will lead to war.
We're going all in to help out Rainsfall and Eagle Fly. Eagle Flies.
They have got stronger. And we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
Well, it's a bad business.
Yeah, you can say that again, Arthur.
I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So...
we're going to drink his milkshake.
Obviously, they can't. And even more,
I mean,
obviously,
yeah, that seems obvious to me.
Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
Arthur.
Pay you very handsome,
come on.
Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you.
Yeah, it's the same.
Like you, I've been running
on,
for
Arthur.
As long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, that appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his.
We must try everything. Come along.
Fran Fry says, have a tip because I'm on vacay and currently a fashion nightmare for that reason. Except for my 60 skeleton shirt. You see, that is a fashion win.
He can see you now.
A 60 skeleton shirt.
I don't know how long.
Or next month.
Outside Xbox and outside extra merch is a fashion win.
The senator
in any situation. I could walk the streets of Saint Denis fashionably. All right, so we're going to go back to camp and do Mary Beth's mission. And we're supposed to meet Eagle Flies in a couple of days, so that'll pop up as well. So let's ride back to camp. Which is down here. I know where it is. So I've been playing a lot of Yakuza Like a Dragon on the Xbox Series X. I was considering streaming that as well, but if you thought that Red Dead Redemption is a kind of cutscene-heavy, story-heavy game. Yakuza Like a Dragon will literally have... You'll finish a mission and then you will have 15 solid minutes of cutscenes. Which is probably not the best stream experience for people watching. There's a stranger over here. Oh, yeah, that's fun. All right, let's do that before we leave town. So we're going to go and meet the Nikola Tesla-style inventor. He seems stable. Someone that we should spend time with. Ashar Otto says, what shirt are you wearing today, Andy? This is Oxbox merch. This is from when we did our PAX appearance in Boston last year. Yeah, this was a limited bit of merch that we had when we were at PAX East, which was a great time. We did an Ox venture, did some meet and greets. A lot of fun.
Thank you, Marco. Thank you.
Laura B says, too bad. Yakuza is great fun. It is really good fun. I'm having a great time with it. Got a video going up about it tomorrow, based on what I've been playing, which I think is going to be really fun. But yeah, I think I'd be able to do about two missions and an hour and a half of cutscenes if I were to stream it. Savior of mankind, buddy.
Yes, you meet him. Professor Marco Dragic. They won the Silver Tongue American Betray and not paid the money to. Yes, he told to shit, man. So,
Ben Sadler says, I might have missed if you said you were still playing on the Series X. Have you tried putting on those coats that were glitch? I'm wondering if they're still glitching. That is a good question. Maybe it's got enough power to handle the coat that always glitches. I can try. Before we finish the stream, I'll change into that coat and see if it glitches again. On a completely different console.
Still the investors will not come. Just a couple of old ladies and a moron.
Ladies, please.
Ladies, gentlemen, enchanté.
I tell you what is impressive about the Series X is the quick resume thing, because I played this last week, saved the game, closed it. Spend the rest of the week, you know, playing Yakuza, playing Sea of Thieves, playing whatever else. You know, turning it off, not playing any more Red Dead Redemption. Loaded it up today for the first time in a week. And it instantly loaded the game that I was playing last time. I was genuinely confused as to what was going on for a second. Yeah, I was quite taken aback. It was very impressive.
I will power this.
You're a goddamn.
Andrew White says, Andy, did you cry when you finished Arthur's story? I don't know if I cried. You know, I felt.
I watched them conspire.
Because in a way, it's an uplifting ending for Arthur. Well, it depends what you do, but. I think Arthur, it's quite uplifting.
No, Professor, George,
you know, he achieved something good at the end.
Only this time let the buffoon
no spoilers.
Check if there's any funny business.
No, this ain't nothing to do with me.
Come, please.
All right, so, if you weren't paying attention, this guy's an inventor. He's invented a new kind of toy boat that's armed with explosive ordnance. And these folks are investors. We want a demonstration. So we've got to blow up. We've got to blow up the toy submarines. Like this, with his torpedoes. Nope, too far away. All right, how about this? There we go. All right, as you can see, this is going to be the hit toy of Christmas 1899. All the kids are going to be out. Oh, mine. All the kids are going to be out on the pond using their tiny TNT torpedoes to blow up ducks and their swimming siblings. Uh-oh. Whoa. All right, what else?
Trapped in a box at the bottom of the bay.
There we go.
I suppose you intend to make an unmanned killing.
Now just to simply thread the needle easily between these two.
Secret to life. Not
I don't know if he's trying to do a demonstration of how good his thing is. I don't know why he filled the pond with mines that could destroy it. That seems like a poor idea.
Well, I'm not sure.
Oh, did that not?
That.
Okay. There's one here still. Come on up. Boom.
All gone for you.
Yes, you see what he does? Now bring the boat back now, to the dock.
That's sure. Simple case.
But I'm not sure what, if anything,
guiding it back to shore. Man, this guy is good at inventing things. He should try and invent a robot son. I bet that would work well. Alright. I don't know why you couldn't do that. You invented it.
This is really remarkable. This is just a demonstration.
Ah, these are sort of great, fun toys you could enjoy in 1899 before you had to worry about how deadly toys were. You know, all these killjoys. Oh, you can't sell that just because it killed 75 children with its exploding bombs.
Still avoiding magnetic mines.
Oh, he'll attempt to at least.
Shush! You're not here for this smart.
All right, what? Just out of interest, because I don't know, I've never done it. What does happen if I blow up this boat full of people? I'm just interested.
The telegraph machine.
Torpedoes away!
They will all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not.
Oh, failed the mission. Probably could have guessed that. Probably. I'm pointing out the flaws in your product, Marco. If you can just kill people with it in public.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess, sir. The real miracles require investment. Now the dimwit will use invisible...
All right, fine. I'm going to destroy the sailboats. I'm not going to sink the rowboat.
They get to other side of car.
Full of assistance.
Still avoiding magnetic mines.
Oh, he'll attempt to at least...
Come on, intercept.
You're
yes. Boom. Point blank.
The telegraph machine. The motor car.
They will oh, turning circle on this thing.
In comparison to this technology, we are not right, reliant on
this
wires
bit of distance.
Or coal or gasoline. No, just rays.
Boom.
In the air.
Yes. Like intercept vector.
And funding from us?
And funding from you, of course, but what being too fun? What an opportunity!
Look who rules the sea! Man, Arthur is so into this, I love it.
Now bring in the boat back here. You avoid the mines, yes?
Yes, I will avoid the mines, not a problem.
Foolproof! Undeniably foolproof!
Alright, so do you want to invest in this deadly, deadly child's toy? Oh! I pressed it. And I immediately regretted it. It's impossible not to. How are you supposed to not shoot at the...
This is really remarkable.
Fine.
This is just a demonstration of my...
The Fingers Mahoney says, have a lovely tip as I finally hit level 5 mustache. Can't believe you picked Tesla over Best Bay. I assume that's over Mary Beth. I will be doing Mary Beth's mission as well. I'll be heading there straight after this. I just, you know, Tesla's hanging out on my path. But, I mean, if I can't stop blowing up civilians with my tiny explosive submarine, I'm not going to get anywhere, am I? It's just so tempting.
The telegraph machine, the motor car.
Boom.
Pedestrian in comparison to this.
All right.
Technology.
And
we are not reliant on wires or
one
coal
more.
Or gasoline. No, just rays in the air. Like the voice.
Or not? Is that it?
And funding from us.
Oh no, it's over here.
Funding from you, of course. But what thing to fund?
I hope
what
that the retail version of this comes with the radar as well. Otherwise, are you going to see where the things you're blowing up are?
Arthur rules the seas.
Yes, Arthur, you rule the seas.
Very good. Now bring in the boat back here. Foolproof.
And don't attack the crowd.
Undeniably foolproof.
Can
the
do.
You are not fools. And unlike fools, not fools and their money are difficultly...
There we go. All right, good.
As I say, any fool, huh? Thank you, thank you.
What is that?
Spiffy Mark says, and now, on Morgan Monday, 2 hours of the toy boat mission.
Incredible things are in my lab.
We're done.
That will astound all of you. Mr. Marcel, can I count on your support?
Well, this is expensive.
It is immortality, sir. It is very cheap. Perhaps over lunch.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go.
Well, I'll be off. My work here is done.
If you're ever up near Dover Hill, pay me a visit. There, I will really amaze you.
I don't know. I'm not impressed by much. It would have to be some kind of robot son to really impress me. All right. Back to camp. Let's go. Out of the way. Spiffy Mark says Arthur's having the time of his life. Correct. Never seen such excellent toys. John Nigma says, I'm surprised this doesn't already exist as an IRL merch toy. Yeah, if they sold this as tie-in merch for Red Dead Redemption 2, can you imagine? All over that. With real explosives. See, I would recommend Yakuza, Like a Dragon, if you have a Series X. I've been playing a lot of that. Digging the turn-based combat in it. It's like an RPG now, but it has it's quite tongue-in-cheek, like a lot of the attacks and stuff. It's got summons in it, but it's all like friends of yours that you call up on your phone, and then they just turn up and do weird stuff. Like I made friends with this guy who's like a romantic movie star, and he sort of turns up and acts out an emotional scene from a movie. And it lowers everyone's defense, who you're fighting against. There's also a crawfish that you can make friends with and phone up, and then they just turn up and hit everyone with their pincers. You know, that kind of standard RPG stuff. All right, back to the Haunted Mansion. Let's see what people want us for. Hey, everyone. How's it going?
I thought you'd run off to join.
Well, well, well. Look who it is. Just hanging out without a care in the world. I think you folks know what time it is.
I should have broken your neck long ago.
Oh, no. Here we go.
You revolting old bastard.
Javier just turned up and started talking to me with the guitar in his hand like he was going to start playing Wonderwall. But he hasn't. Good news. All right, let's see what we got this week. Oh, come on, Arthur. Get some new material.
Bring in no money and drink 10 times your share.
Dang, if you ain't difficult.
All right, well, it's not new material, but it does... I mean, that's almost more disrespectful to Uncle. That we couldn't even bother to think up new insults to roast him with. So I'm happy with that. That's a pretty good roasting in my book. Hey, Mary Beth, what's up?
Hello, Mary Beth.
Oh, how are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
Well, I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
So well-dressed. So,
no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Oh, for John and this... band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
Don't light matches on the soles of those extremely expensive boots, Arthur.
That all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Oh, that great.
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. I wouldn't change.
Gildos says lightly roasted Dunkel pairs well with his incessant whine.
She definitely was a fool.
In these books,
love for Mary Beth in the comments.
I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken.
So this is one of those missions where it says it's a Mary Beth mission, and then someone just barges in and is like, now it's my mission. Let's go.
I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure.
All right. Do we need I guess Mary Beth will do your mission some other time.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going. All right, head for Rhodes.
And we're off to Rhodes to save Tilly.
No, she's at a place called Bradley's house, just west of there.
How do you know?
Tilly's got into some trouble.
She told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house, that gang she ran with you.
But not for long, because Arthur's on the way.
And you told Dutch?
No, she spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
Now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremen hassling her in Valentine.
Yeah, we put a stop to that.
Yes, they probably followed us.
All right,
down.
Time to put a permanent stop to this. It's just going to keep happening.
She killed one of them for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she...
All right, so she killed one of them in self-defense, and now they're mad about it.
Fell in with us right after that. I just hope get to her in time.
So I guess we'll just have to kill a whole bunch of more of them in self-defense. Oh, okay. Ms. Grimshaw's going to do it for me.
That's the place up ahead.
I think there's a guard.
All right.
I'll deal with him.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa. What you want?
Kind sir. We're lost and in need of some help.
Now get out of here.
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours, and I know that for the right...
All right, what have you got, Ms. Grimshaw?
A gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that. You don't mean nothing by
I
it.
I said...
Wow. Damn.
Well,
yikes.
Get in there and find
out... Run the neck. All right, well, waste not, what not.
I'll take that.
Hello.
Shit! What the hell, you dead?
Hello, anyone? No. Arthur, do you want to... Maybe look at the guy who's shooting you. Thanks. All right, who else we got? Is that it? There we go.
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Five of them?
Well,
all right.
We killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine.
Hell yeah. All right, let's go. Go on, Miss Grimshaw.
Get after them.
Shoot them all. From horseback.
The
tail gunner.
I saw him go through those bushes. You've got a couple more seconds to regret what you did.
Hold still.
They're heading down the
there
hill.
There we go.
Oh, there they are by the shoreline.
Right. Where are the others?
Yep.
That was good. Managed to not kill the horse. Don't have to break out the song if I don't have to.
We're coming for you, you bastards!
Oof!
Come on.
Oh, I'm using the shotgun. That looks fun.
Think they're getting away? They got another thing coming. All right, I think that last one...
Can get him from here?
Yeah.
Lasso him and we'll take him back to
the ship. Oh, right, okay.
Tilly can't speak to
him if he's dead, Arthur.
Come here.
That's it. Now make sure you time up.
There we go. Nice arm. Good throw. Sorry about shooting you three times. I was unclear on the mission objectives. You understand how it is.
Back to Tilly, so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure.
I'll take his horse. He won't.
Loving this Dalmatian horse. That's cool.
Do you have the first idea what you're getting into? I'm Anthony Ford.
Mm-hmm.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an E? I want the Undertaker.
Nice,
to
Arthur, nice.
Right.
Just give him a little. Just give him a little tap. Just a little tap.
Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. This rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
All right, shouldn't take long. We didn't get far, I think.
Goddamn cousin.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
Yeah, here we are.
What are you gonna do with me?
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You're wasting your...
All right.
Wow. Oh, my God. Look at the bullet holes. Oh, and the horse pooping right there. It'd be a shame if someone were to just pop you down on it.
So he's still
yep.
alive then?
Yep. A bit, mostly.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman. I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur.
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave
yeah.
me alone.
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony?
Just shave his beard off.
Or should I?
Just whisk that beard off. He's obviously proud of it.
Leave you alone.
Oh, you can see my cool customized knife with all the skulls on it. In a cutscene, finally.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat. Go on.
I'm obviously going to spare him. That's what Tilly wants.
Come on. Let's get you home.
Now get out of here.
Chicken Parmesan says, since you can't skin horses in the game, disappointing you can't skin this one and get a Dalmatian coat. Let us live our Wild West Cruella de Vil fantasy. That'd be fun.
Yep. There we
well,
go.
Waste not, one not before I leave. Let's just do some looting. No? Alright, fine. Maybe in this saddlebag. Anything? Chewing tobacco. Not bad. Alright. What do we got now? Stranger mission. Oh, there's the Eagle Flies mission up there. Alright, I'll go back to camp, get my proper horse back, and then we can fast travel over to the Eagle Flies mission, see what that is.
Yep. Now, come on.
Shy Violet says, what is that imposter horse? That's not Lil Steedy. I know. I'm taking it back to camp. It can become one of the camp horses. That's fine. But maybe I'll lead it into camp rather than ride it in, otherwise Steedy might get jealous. Abby Johnson says, don't mind me just drooling over every Belle Epoque detail. Okay, what? Brilliant. Thanks, mate. Cool. Man, I love Auto Horse. It works so well. Oh, my God. Why does this always happen? Do you see now that that horse was bad? It was a disloyal and bad horse. Horse, I know we just met, but be loyal. Come back. Come back, you disloyal horse. Am I basically at... Yeah, all right, fine. It's fine, you live in the woods. You see if I care. Oh, my stamina. Treat myself to some cocaine gum. The great taste of... Oh, what, you're back now? Oh, Steedy, I see. Yeah, Steedy. Steedy would never betray me this way. Good old Steedy.
Hey, who's there?
It's me. Arthur.
It's me, Arthur.
All right, cool.
Welcome back.
Hey, Arthur.
Lenny, all good here?
Now, I think fast travel's in my room, I want to say. I think. Let's go and find out. Alright, I'll treat Steedy to some oatcakes when I fast travel. Yeah, I'm kind of busy, Miss Grimshaw.
Man, Mr. Morgan. Sometimes, at least.
Thank you. I think.
Alright. Take the opportunity to shave as well. Got some stubble coming in. Do I do that in here? Can I shave in? Yeah, here we go. There we go. Much better. Alright, so we're going to kerosene and tar, which is up here, like Emerald Ranch kind of way. Ah, it's closer to Valentine. Alright, let's just go to Valentine. Cool. Ryan M says, having a blast watching this while doing coursework. Thanks for the fun content as always. You're welcome, Ryan, and good luck with the coursework. Hope it goes well. Will Mosher says, is the skin stuck on there? That happened on one of my playthroughs as well. It isn't. I could take it off if I want and sell it. I want to keep Steedy warm. It's nice. Sweet Monkey Tuesday says, it must be really rank by now. It's been on there for about 5 streams. It's probably been treated by the weather. Now it's sort of leathery and nice, probably, I expect. Alright, back in Valentine, where I assume I'm beloved by all. Yes? Good. Oh, hey, it's these guys.
My friend. You there?
Hey, friends, what's up?
Yeah? What do you want?
Do I look like a cat?
I don't know, kinda.
I mean, obviously,
if you had a big mustache like mine,
like that
would help.
But 'tis no matter. Can you help?
Maybe.
See? Even he is sick of hearing your nonsense, you afterthought of a child. I apologize, sir, for his smell. Why don't we come back here, to somewhere more conducive to displays of utter gallantry and deep-seated inadequacy?
Well, what did you have in mind?
Shoot a bottle.
Oh. You don't want to ask me to do that, friend. You know I'm going to just get the irresistible urge to dead-eye you directly in the crotch.
Shoot one off mine instead.
Again, I will warn you up front. Probably going to shoot you in the crotch.
I won't even flinch.
You might flinch if I shoot you in the crotch, though.
I can't lose. Either I'll prove my masculinity or die and be spared his company. Come, sir, please.
Okay, then. Listen, just make sure everyone knows you asked me to do this.
Of course, of course, of course.
You boys are ridiculous.
Okay.
Oh no, it's the bad guy gun.
Don't think too much about it.
Look, I told you. I did warn you. I'm sorry. It's irresistible. All right, retry checkpoint. I'm sorry, Proteus died. All right, let me just here we go.
You got my
good shot. That was fun. What was? I feel like we didn't even do anything.
Oh, of course you didn't. We all know you're hardly sentient at all.
Another round, smaller bottles, sir. Please.
That can't be good for you to have a bottle shot of your head. Please. Still glass in your face and eyes and hair.
He needs silencing.
I'll do my best. As long as she witnesses that I'm doing this under duress.
You boys are so
all right. Well, this is gonna be a tougher shot, guys. I don't know if I can make it this time. Oh no! Oh no! It happened again. Oh no! Oh, why does this keep happening? Oh. Oh, Proteus. So sorry. All right, this time for sure. Smaller bottles. It's all good. It's all good.
He got it. Of course.
There we go.
Now I'll stand on one leg. Me too. You keep shooting, sir, and this time you kill the beast.
If you're sure.
Fully formed from the swamps, Helen.
Silence, you blackguard, sir. Shoot the wretch.
All right, Proteus, if you're sure, I can try and make the shot, but my gun arm's feeling a bit loose, and oh no, oh Proteus, oh, happened again. Oh, Proteus. I wonder if any of this metadata goes back to Rockstar. There's someone in a data center somewhere going, what?
Ready?
What?
You're deranged.
What? He did what?
Shoot away, sir. My bottle and his brains.
Oh, come on.
Please.
Excuse me.
At least I have.
Thank you.
Excellent. Fine shooting.
There we go.
Now do one while I hop. Do one while I turn somersaults. Shoot me. Oh, give me the gun. Let me shoot him. For all mankind.
I think me and the lady have had enough.
Oh, I don't blame you, sir. This man's tongue, I would run too if I could. Here, for your skills and talents.
Thank you.
Now, brother, I am going to walk
with my crutch intact. Thank you very much.
Elderly aunt, and I fear the sight of you could finally finish her off. Helen, is this creep bothering you?
You two, come along.
Oh, no, there aren't two. There's me and the lizard man. Please, my angel, do not aggregate us both together.
Boys, you are too much. You are too much.
No, my sweet.
All right, well, I think we've done some good here today. I think we can all be proud. I'm going to take the chat suggestion from earlier. I'm going to try changing into the scout jacket and see if it's still a glitchy nightmare.
Have a look around.
So, I guess fashion intro again, because we're going to build a new outfit. Okay, so we're going to get the collar open. That's good. No vest for the moment, just while I check this out. A scout jacket. Yeah, that's just that one, isn't it? How's that looking? Maybe a vest underneath. Is that too much? I don't hate it. Got any better trousers for this? Yeah, maybe not the best. Yeah, that's all right. Let me swap out the hat, maybe. Yeah, there we go. And then let me just match the gloves to the jacket. There we go. All right, let's see if this jacket is a glitching nightmare. Nate Klein says, "Why I didn't end up loving this game as much as you on the whole, Andy. Here's for convincing me to give it a try and experience Arthur's story." Well, I'm glad that you got some enjoyment out of it. I understand it's not for everyone, this game. But yeah, I think it's still one of the most impressive video games ever made. It's definitely worth trying if you haven't. Right, where... Here we go, Eagle Flies. All right, Steedy. Auto horse me. All right. I haven't had a Morgan Mystery for a while either, which means I haven't got to play the Morgan Mysteries intro. So hopefully something mysterious will happen, because I missed that. Leah AK says, "For the crotch shots!" And then party emoji, me emoji, pressure memes emoji. Samorio Suni says, "When you said camp horses, I thought you meant like, nay darling. Also, Proteus's banter is reminiscent of Handsome Jack." Yeah, I mean, not when he's being shot in the crotch, but just generally. Alberto T says, "Just want to say thank you. You're the reason I picked up RDR2 last year. Just got a copy of RDR with the Undead Nightmare DLC and excited to play it for the first time." Oh, you're going to have a great time. Undead Nightmare is really good fun. Red Dead Redemption is really good fun. Yeah, enjoy it. Oh, hey, Lolis is in the chat saying, "Give us an intro." All right. Let's show Lolis one of the intros. Which one do you guys want to see? We've got John and Arthur. We've got the Morgan Mysteries. We've got Skull Rider, or Legendary Animals. So, out of those four, which do you want to see? Morgan Mysteries, Skull Rider, John and Arthur, or Legendary Animals? Let me know in the chat. Elvis Press Play says the John and Arthur song. Alright, I'm gonna hit John and Arthur. Here we go.
John, I've got one aim. To make us best friends by the end of the game. Sharing special moments like us robbing a train. I hope you feel the same.
I am also seeing a lot for Skull Rider, and to be fair, that is probably my current favourite, so I'm also going to play Skull Rider. So please enjoy Skull Rider.
Thank you.
God, I would watch the hell out of that show. Don't know about you lot. Anyway, the important thing is we're here to help eagle flies, not revel in my great, great intros. So. Oh my god, there's a Sadie mission on my map. Oh my god, I didn't even realize. Alright, fine. Eagle flies and then Sadie. Wait, let me just pick and examine this mushroom. Cool. All right, eagle flies, what's up?
You came.
Of course I came. Said I would.
There's a foreman. His name is Danbury. Is the files in the office above the refinery room. There. You see that light up there?
I see it.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm
Stephen Clamett says, so you're going to create a shot them in the crotch intro now. I don't know if it's going to happen enough to warrant an intro.
You got the money?
But maybe. Maybe if I shoot more people in the crotch. Sweet Monkey Tuesday says, RDR2 just needed difficulty settings that alters how important managing the cores were and a New Game Plus option.
I thought the whole point.
I don't know if New Game Plus would be good. I mean, it's... Yeah, I don't know if it's the kind of game that would benefit from a New Game Plus. Sneak into the factory. Oh, okay. Sneak into the back. Sorry, pay attention. Come on, in you go. Nice. Now we can see what's what from here. Nick Jeffrey says, here's a donation to go towards the intro fund. These streams will eventually be 90 minutes of intros and 30 minutes of dressing Arthur and nothing else. That's the dream. That's ideal. While we go in, I don't think we're going to get to a Morgan Mysteries today, so I'm just going to play the Morgan Mysteries intro as well, because otherwise I'll feel sad about missing it. Right, great news, friends. We've infiltrated Cornwall, kerosene and tar. Stealthily. Stealthy-like. And probably won't have to shoot anyone at all. It's going to be great.
I'm going to start loading up.
So now to... Wait. Are they gone? Now to just simply exit the wagon. Not even a problem. Do you want to let me turn the camera at all? Oh, I'm still in cinematic camera, that will be why. Okay, now to sneak into the factory. Here we go. Probably going upstairs would be the way to do it, right? Because then I'll be up top. Which is where you want to be, no? Ah, open window, nice. What? How is the... What's wrong with that? How did he just... Why did he destroy the documents? You tell me, friends. I have no idea.
If you are quick,
well...
You could climb into the back of that wagon.
Got to do the whole thing again! Alright, jeez, game. Chill out. Lixie Lou says, for the intros fund. And Odd Animation says, have you tried out Baldur's Gate 3, D&D 5e, but a video game? Here's some coin for the Don't Become a Mind Flayer fund. You become a Mind Flayer, is that a thing that happens? I remember killing a Mind Flayer, easily, myself. But becoming a Mind Flayer sounds like a... yeah, not keen. Amberlita says, not seeing any jacket glitching just goes to show that RDR2 was so ahead of its time, it needed a next-gen console to run optimally. Not even to run optimally, just to display jackets properly. That's how good the jackets are. He saw you through the window. He had his back to me. He saw nothing. Spotted absolutely nothing. All right, fine. I'm gonna...
hey, Tom?
Gonna sneak in more sneakily this time.
I'm supposed to meet the early train to San Denis. Okay.
Saw me through the window, indeed. William Kruger says, just remember, Andy, your original name for Skull Rider was Crunchy Man. A breakfast cereal sponsorship, perhaps. Was it? Oh, man. Yeah, Crunchy Man's not great. I think I was trying to come up with a sort of, like, urban legend, you know, like Slender Man. Alright. I don't know what I was thinking. Crunchy Man is bad. Skull Rider's great. Alright, now the sneakening. So we're not going to go up onto the roof. But can I at least go onto the second floor, please? Can I at least come in here? Of course not. Why would I? Why would I? Alright. I guess we're stealthing. I guess it's Hitman now. Oh. That was close. Right, come on, Arthur. I knock someone out and put on their clothes. Well, they're all dressed like me anyway. Wouldn't really help, I don't think. Go, go, go. This is why I was trying to get in on the second floor. Alright, he's over there. Let's just go for it. I'm assuming it's this brightly lit door and not this completely dark door. So let's, hello? You better not instantly destroy the documents like you did last time. Some kind of flash paper it's made out of.
Quieten yourself, friend. This won't take long.
Anyway, so I'll just be giving you a light beating. Just a little. There we go. Just a, oh, wow. Penalty kick to the head.
I'm from head office.
I'm from head office. Yeah, this is our new management style. It's
No.
Sent down from the top.
By the Leland Oil Development Company.
Now that guy's... all right, your mustache is bigger than mine, so I'm going to beat you a bit more. I hate to see it. I just need the files.
Danbury. Think, man. Mind is a terrible thing to lose. Especially over such a nice...
yeah, this floor is nice. Oh, wow! Wow! Come on, Arthur.
It's here. It's here.
It's where now? Should I put on his hat as an intimidation tactic? That's right. I'm you now. What do you think of that? And I'll be taking my file.
You've done good, Danbury. Real good. They'll give you a promotion for this. Nope. Danbury.
Danbury? Danbury, you okay?
Tell the
Are you okay, Danbury?
Yes, it's just... I'm working. All's fine.
Yeah, that was real convincing.
Now stay quiet. Our head office will send me back to get you.
Got anything else worth stealing, Danbury? Ooh, a cigar. How am I off for cigars? Yeah, I need a cigar. Great. Don't mind if I do, Danbury. Take the cigar, Arthur. Oh, fine. I'm not actually going to leave with this hat because it sucks, but I think it sent the right message. Anything else I can rob? I feel like there should be. No? No? All right. Guess we're going out the window. Whee! And... no. All right. Thought Steedy might be waiting for me. Brilliant. Glad I did all that stealth. Whee! All right. Find Eagle. Oh, God. What's he... Eagle flies up to anyway? I don't even know. I assume he was the one who blew up the thing. For which, thank you. Alright, let's go. Come on, fellas. The place is on fire. Probably best to just ride it off, yeah? Claim on the insurance. In the back. That's a shame. By Jesse James. Eagle flies. Yeah, I got him. Oh, wait. Sorry, Steedy, I didn't see you there. That was embarrassing. Let's go! Come on, Eagle Flies! Oh, really? Alright. What have I got? Got so many guns. There we go. Bolt action. Dude! Not cool. There's rules about not ramming into each other's horses. Oh man, that horse is in a bad way. Can I use a horse reviver on it? Oh no, it's alright. It's alright. It's okay, folks. The horse is okay. Great news. Eagle flies. The horse is okay. I think we're good.
That explosion came just in time.
I was happy to watch some of that oil burn. So you met Mr. Danbury?
Yes, don't worry. He was very obliging. I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were going to enter and leave silently.
I did. I did enter and leave the building silently.
Thank you.
I just, for some reason, slid down onto some people.
I don't know what I hope. But who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Thank you.
Nathaniel Levesque says, if you use an exploit at the Aberdeen Pig Farm towards the end of the main story, you can transfer Arthur's money to John. But John has, like, tons of money anyway, right? You start with loads of money when you're John, I'm pretty sure. I don't feel like I ever needed money. I guess it's always good to have more. But yeah, the Aberdeen Pig Farm is pretty messed up. I don't know if you want to actively go out of your way to do it. All right, I'm going to go and see Sadie, I think. Sadie wants us to do something. What do you want, Sadie? Oh, hell yeah, look at that thumbnail. Sadie just going absolutely buck wild on some dude. I'm doing that mission. Hell yeah. All right. I can fast travel from camp, right? That's a thing you can do these days. Let's find out. Chicken Parmesan says, ever consider doing a voted challenge stream? Like, do the stream using the bow only or something to that effect? Or would that be too challenging? Food for thought to add some random comedy moments. Yeah, that would be fun. I don't know if I'm good enough at Red Dead Redemption to actually do challenges, but which is the closest city? Is it Rhodes or is it? That's much of a muchness, isn't it? I'll go to Rhodes. Jordan Jessup says, "Do you still have the Valentine song intro?" I do. I don't have it loaded onto my stream deck, unfortunately. I didn't think I'd need it anymore because, you know, not spending much time in Valentine anymore. But that was fun. Maybe I'll load it back on there just in case. Sketching 101 is a new member. Thank you very much for joining. Appreciate it. Frodo Baggins says, is it a Sadie mission, though, or does Uncle come in and demand you do a mission instead? Oh, the thumbnail had Sadie being cool in it. They wouldn't do that, surely. They wouldn't do that to me. I've got to believe they wouldn't do something so cruel. Dangle a Sadie Adler mission in front of me and then yank it out of the way and force a stupid uncle mission.
Wow, Morgan, I've found a bank that needs robbing. Oh, it's real easy. There's only one guard and he's dead.
And then you turn up. They got an attack helicopter. Well, what's this attack helicopter, Uncle? You didn't mention this.
I didn't know they had an attack helicopter. Why are you always getting on my case?
That's exactly how it would go. And then I'd say, you revolting old bastard. And we'd all laugh. We've had a lot of fun here today, folks. There's nothing uncool about teen diabetes. You know how it goes. You folks have seen Uncle. Here we are. When the crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake, I'm back to do a mission for Sadie. Alright, where's she hanging out? She's probably practicing her stabbing out back. Probably wrestling a gator.
Good morning, Arthur.
Probably just knifing a bear. Oh no, wait, here she is on the steps. What are you doing, Sadie? Sharpening your knife? Ready for stabbing? Yeah, that's cool.
How you doing, Mrs. Adler?
How are you? Been quite a journey since I joined you fellas.
Digging my look, by the way.
Yes.
And now
what do you guys think?
Dutch have joined high society. My lord above.
Yeah, it seems so.
I think my days in polite society are over.
She said, brandishing a knife.
I just saw Bill Williamson at a party at the San Denise mayor's house. If he can do it, anyone can.
You get any leads?
Yeah, I think so.
You know so, Arthur Morgan. Come on.
Dwayne G donates saying, just for Sadie being the best.
Sadler, will you excuse
thanks,
us?
I'll pass it on.
Are you going to let me come robbing with you, Dutch?
My lord, a few more like her, we could take over the whole world.
A few more like her, there wouldn't be much of a world left.
Yes, perhaps. Now, the trolley bus station. I went down there.
Now, you see what's happened?
I took a look at it.
Is this has gone from a Sadie mission?
I think we can hit it.
To a Dutch mission.
I've never robbed in a city before.
Well, you leave the planet.
They've done it again.
You'll ride with me.
They pulled the switcheroo.
Is it just you and me?
No, we'll need one more, I reckon.
I say,
not Micah.
Well, that depends if you want a massacre or a payday.
No, I wish that there was something I could do to make the two of you go.
Because they know if they put
better.
Dutch mission on there, everyone's going to be like, no thanks.
Very funny.
Spoon of Doom said, what would you do if RDR3 made you play his uncle?
What is that?
Oh, man. Oh, this bit. Yeah. Oh, I've forgotten about this.
What the hell have they done to me?
So Kieran's not in a good way.
There, the tree line.
Everybody take cover! O'Driscoll boys are coming!
Man, you promised me a Sadie mission. You dangled the carrot. Now, Kieran's head is off. I've got to shoot a bunch of O'Driscolls. This is honestly unforgivable. Wouldn't catch Yakuza like a dragon doing that, Red Dead. When they're like, oh, you need to go and have a fist fight with a chimp in an excavator, that's exactly what you get. They don't bait and switch you. All right, time to vault excitingly over the banister. Wait, what am I doing? Oh, I'm going out back. Wait. Okay, I guess I'm going out. Out front. Fine.
What's happening?
Crystal. Hold in here. Stay away from the window.
You tell Mr. Pearson.
Everyone get inside. I'll shoot everyone for you. As usual. Everyone but Kieran. Yes, no, I gathered that much. Thanks. Have they all got bags on their heads? Like Jason Voorhees. Hey. 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 That's enough out of you. And you. And additionally you. I mean, sure, I wasn't Kieran's biggest fan, but come on. No cutting people's heads off. All right, John said fall back to the house, and he would know. All right, Resident Evil 4 style. And barricade ourselves in with a bookshelf.
Good. Now everyone, I got this. Get these windows covered quickly. John, you take the windows over there. Charles, you take the side doors there. Arthur, you take the windows in the back. Go.
How do you even set that up? Like, how do you even get his head in his hands and have the horse trot slowly in?
I think. Hey, I said it's everyone accounted for.
I don't know.
Nope.
I think.
Come on. There you go. So I forget. I think it's a. I can't remember if it's a Halloween or a Friday the 13th film. I think it's a Friday the 13th. But there's one where it's someone comes home and they open their fridge and there's like a severed head in the fridge and then they scream and then Jason turns up.
That's
Mrs. You know, obviously all horror movie scary and stuff. But it's if you think about it for a second. The fact that Jason had to go and put a head in someone's fridge. Dutch, can you not, please? Thank you. Oh, my God. There we go.
Get out there. She's in trouble.
I'm doing what now? Going outside.
I'm covering.
All right.
Sadie, I'm coming!
Sadie!
Sadie?
She's got it. Look, that guy's... Whoa, whoa, whoa. Sadie's going buck wild.
Sadie?
You all right?
Why didn't you get inside?
And miss all this? Come on, Arthur!
Protect Sadie. I think it's going to be the other way around, game. God, Deadeye. Are they coming by boat? All sorts going on. Who else we got? Anyone? Anyone say he hasn't already named? The tree is too wide to be cover. Come on. There we go. Good. Okay. All right, Sadie. Thanks for the help. You okay? Oh my God, it's even more of them. It's so weird that the Vandalin gang and the O'Driscolls are like rival gangs, considering that the amount of O'Driscolls you kill, they've got to be like, there's got to be like 1,000 members of the O'Driscoll gang. And it, like, you see every single member of the Vandalin gang. There's like 12 of them.
We okay? I think so. Except for Kieran here. Poor kid.
Kieran's in a bad way.
Could you take this boy and bury him someplace near, but
can you save him? Hosea?
Charles, help me with the body.
You know any medicine, medical tricks?
Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw!
Already taking care of it. Come on now, work!
Gross.
Como Driscoll. That man can really hate. So can I, Arthur. So can I. We need to get moving. Away from here.
So we should start looking for another camp.
You ain't thinking big enough, Arthur. You ain't seeing the vastness of our problems and our opportunities.
I'm not sure I get you.
You will, son. You will. Meet me near the trolley station. We got work.
Shall we?
Yep.
Insert clever name says, is it bad to hope that the boat guys aren't O'Driscolls, but just NPCs who had a hilariously bad timing in planning a fishing trip? I hope not. That'd be tragic.
Powerful forces I scarcely understand.
Just a peaceful day's canoeing.
That's what love has done to her, I guess.
Oh, boy. Well, that was a lot messier than I was expecting. Some time has passed, some stubble has grown in, but you know what, with this outfit I think I'm going to keep it for the rugged look, which I'm enjoying. Alright, we've got a Dutch mission. Which is the one where we rob the trolley? Again, another genius Dutch Vandalin plan that goes flawlessly. So,
he was such a generous soul.
Yeah, he saved my life one time. I'll miss him.
You make the bastards pay, Arthur.
If we get the chance, we surely shall.
That's rough. All right, we're going to head to Saint-Denis and do Dutch's cool, great plan to rob the trolley. And, you know, I give Dutch a hard time a lot. I say his plans are bad and that he's an idiot. But I think we should give him the benefit of the doubt. He's got a plan. He thinks it's going to work. He has a lot of experience in, you know, being a crime man. So I think we should just give Dutch the benefit of the doubt and do his plan to rob the trolley. I think he's always asking us to have faith, isn't he? So let's do him that courtesy. And let's have faith in Dutch's plan. And see how it goes. Soj King says, this is the intro fund. While watching your Destiny stream, I was waiting for the fashion intro when you were talking about shaders. Yeah. There is some really good fashion potential in Destiny, I would say. Some of those color combinations are great. Elvis Pressplay says, it is telling that the most successful crime you've pulled off was primarily planned by Hosea. Yeah, weird that, isn't it? Probably just a coincidence. All right, and now to do Dutch's cool and good plan that will go well. Can't wait.
Excuse me, sir. Can I bother you?
You certainly can. What's the problem?
Nice to see you again, sir.
Clear the way.
Did you change your mind about donating by any chance? We could really use your support to improve the lives of our veterans and their families.
What are they building? A memorial hall. Oh, okay, I see. Well, good luck with it. Hope it goes well.
Well, you have a nice day.
Junior Flake says, can you shoot Dutch in the crotch? I think I would probably fail the mission, but you never know. Stray bullets, you know. Never know what's going to happen. Oh, Jedi Spartan 38 says donate. It gets Arthur's name in the epilogue. All right, fine. All right, here you go.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you.
All right, here's the money.
Very kind. What is your name, sir?
Don't tell your real name.
Your donation will be acknowledged.
God, so bad at this.
Plaque when the building is completed. You have a great
so bad at this, Arthur. About being an undercover criminal. Probable ray tracing. I don't really know what ray tracing is, but that's probably it. Rays are being traced like crazy. What's even on this trolley that's worth robbing? Does anyone know? I don't. Dutch, what are you? Where are you? Also, who do I have mail from? I'm gonna find out.
Look out!
Hey. My Amazon Prime locker. What have I got? Invitation from Mayor Lemieux. That sounds important.
Thank you.
Monsieur Kilgore, see, alias. I did notice you were near my study when Pierre had an accident and some documents disappeared. As if you were in the party. Come to the back of the mayor's house at night. All right, yeah, that sounds totally legit. All right, fine. All right, I'll go and see the mayor right after I rob this trolley. How's it going, Dutch? Skulking in an alley? That's cool.
There you are. Come on. Keep walking. You're late.
A couple of days in this place, you turned into some clock-watching city boy. What's the urgency?
We need to leave. Forever. We've been doing well, making money. But for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat.
We've got $10,000 or something, Dutch. Feel like we could probably get a boat for that.
To Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear, be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific, an untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians.
Yeah, Tahitians.
I guess.
You got it.
We made a bit of money on that riverboat job, but not enough for us to leave and live peacefully. Where's the rest coming from?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place.
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing.
Yes, you're not doing anything illegal right now. You don't have to
we
hide.
Are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days before the Pinkerton show, and then we're done. Now, we need money. Bronte said this place has got money. Come on.
Okay, so this is, I guess, this is the plan.
This is a robbery.
Oh,
behave as
jacket's
I tell
going weird.
And none of you will die. Annoy me, and you are.
All right.
Now, remember, we just want money. Don't make us kill you. Mr. M.
Mr. M.
Mr. S, check that room back there.
Now, how anyone's going to crack this.
That's your choice.
Please,
amazing
please
code that we've got going on.
Kindly open that gate.
Now, I'm going to need everything you got on you.
It's yours. Have it.
I said.
Oh, 52 cents. Man, this robbery is great. We're raking it in, Dutch. We'll be in Tahiti in no time. This is real Tahiti money right here.
Okay. Fine, it's yours.
92 cents. Ah, it's all going so well.
There's nothing really here.
You're sure?
Yes.
Then get out here and get ready for company. All of you. Behave. We don't want to hurt any of you. Mr. M, check the safe.
All right.
Sure. Open it.
I don't think they keep much cash in there.
Open it.
All right, Dutch. Here it is, the big score.
There's almost nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it. Damn!
We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Come on now! We got you surrounded!
That
say
greasy son
now
of a bitch! Set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time. You are good.
We're gonna do, gentlemen,
something.
We had to drag Lenny into this.
The trolley! Follow me, gentlemen!
Now, to make a speedy getaway. Oh, imagine if it did, though. Alright. Guess we'll murder every cop in town. For however much we just got there. 50 cents or whatever. I guess it's just suppressing fire, right? Although, but oh yeah, lots of riders on the left. I see what you mean.
Coming out of the bank on the right. That bastard must have called in every cop in the city.
Ow.
Oh damn.
Ugh.
Really moving here.
Nice plan, Dutch. Sure, I'll just figure out the controls of an electric trolley.
The thing's
brilliant.
Hold on!
The plan is flawless, Arthur. Why can't you just admit for once I've got a good plan? I've seen a lot of people say that, like, this is the mission that sort of starts Dutch's decline. He gets the head injury, and then he's all sort of paranoid and weird after this mission. But I think he's always like that. I don't think he changes much after this point, to be honest. I think he's pretty terrible, pretty much constantly throughout this entire game. Oh, don't you shoot Lenny! Who's shooting Lenny?
Okay, let's move. Come on.
Who among you has the guts to try and shoot my Lenny? There you go.
Lenny, my boy.
Alright. Yeah, Lenny's in charge now. That's why we're gonna live. Hey.
We can't let them follow us.
Who's banisters?
I'll lead you out. This way. Onto the street.
Yes, Lenny. I'm gonna have a vote for new gang leader when we get back. I'm voting for Lenny. Going this way. Yeah, it's been a real bad run, hasn't it, Dutch? I wonder why. Ugh, man, my dead eye. Let me just real quickly scarf down some oregano prime beef. I know it doesn't seem like the time, but weirdly, it's exactly the time. Any Americans watching, yes, that is how British people pronounce oregano. I know.
Let's move up, guys.
Where are we going, Lenny? I know you're in charge. Oh no! Oh no, I shot the horse! Oh no, the real tragedy.
Keep that weapon. Tact, okay? We might need it.
Could you at least have let me bring my good guns, Dutch?
For that wagon.
Would help. Ooh! Nearly shot Dutch. Yeah. Maybe don't blame everything on it. That's my advice. Do you want to knock? Thank you. I think Dutch shot that horse. Which tracks, that's a pretty Dutchy thing to do. He's a real Dutch bag. Wow, these guys are resilient. Who there's more of, the O'Driscolls or the Sandini Police Department?
Just head straight for the bridge.
This is a very shooty stream, folks. Have to figure out something we can do next time that's a bit more non-violent.
They blocked the road. Hold on. Use this.
Try and shoot what? $165 bounty. I hope you're planning on paying that, Dutch.
Yeah.
That's like $1 trillion in today's money.
I think we're clear.
You know what, Dutch? Next time... It's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Let's divide these riches.
And we each got
$15. I just gave more than that for a children's hospital or something.
Get the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up. Played me like a yokel. Put the law on us. What do we do to him? What did I do to him?
I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, what are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need money.
Cara Denison says, just check the exchange rate. It's actually 750,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,
Even after that?
Especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on. I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey.
Yeah, Lenny.
Feel good there, Lenny. Just wish.
I just want to address everyone on this mission. And I just want to say, Lenny, you did good. That's it. That's all I'm saying. No one else did. Brill, good stuff. Hey, good times. Charles Chatney wants to see us. We can round out the stream with the sexy adventures of Charles Chatney.
Okay then, girl.
What does Dutch want? Oh, okay. Or there's Dutch's mission, where we feed Angelo Bronte to an alligator. I think we're going to go and see Charles Chatney, and we're going to have a fun time with his weird erotic romps. But first, I'm going to need to pay off this bounty, because thanks a lot, Dutch. You enormous Dutch bag. Horse gear. I'm just going to ride back into town like literally 3 minutes after I just shot 50 cops. Hello. Yeah, I know things went a bit awry last time, but here's $165. We cool? Oh, yeah, that's gonna happen. Great, so now Angelo Bronte's guys are mad at me. And the cops. At least the cops aren't shooting me on sight. No, they are. That's cool. I'm even gonna be able to pay this off. Might not let me because of my wanted status. Look, it was all a big misunderstanding. Why can't you just be cool? Probably could have seen that coming. Just get out of the old search and zone.
Yep.
Ah, international waters. Can't touch me. Yeah, maritime law. You have no jurisdiction. Wait for the meter to drain, and then I'll stealth my way to the post office, pay off the bounty. Problem solved. Right. Now we just gotta avoid the cops. Right, Stevie, this is a stealth mission. As much as I love you, you are not a stealthy horse. You are too chonky.
roads.
Easy
great.
There.
Clear, watch out.
Let's go. Okay. I can just pay this off. I won't have to change my outfit. The worst possible outcome. Oh. I did just rob it, didn't I? That's probably why it's shut. All right. And I can't use the stagecoach because, sure. This all makes sense. All right, I'll pay it elsewhere, Saint-Denis. What do you think of that? I'll leave town. Pay it in another town. Yeah. That's right. Your law can't get me.
Let's go, girl.
Yeah. I guess it was optimistic to expect the post office that I just robbed to allow me to pay off the bounty I got for robbing the post office. But you know, that's why we dream, isn't it? You gotta dream big. Okay. Just get out of town, fast travel somewhere else, pay the bounty, fast travel back. Not even a problem. Can't believe those guys in the post office were so uncool. It was like 5 minutes ago. They're not even over it yet. It's not like I shot any of them. Some people. Pop over to Rhodes. Ditchboy says, can you put together a Jason Voorhees outfit? I do have a hockey mask, sort of. I don't know if there's anything like his overalls, though. I could definitely do the mask, that's for sure. Patrick Long says, pretty sure the O'Driscolls somehow have every single American Irishman given their numbers. Somehow by RDR1, Dutch himself has that many gang members. Yeah, not when I'm in his gang. As soon as he goes on his own, suddenly. Where's that mask? There we go. Oh wait, that's a different one. I've got so many weird masks. There we go. It's kind of fetching, right? It doesn't really go with the outfit. Why have you done up your shirt, Arthur?
Hey, out of the way. I'm on a tight schedule.
How has that happened?
Unbelievable.
Right. Have to visit the changing room. Honestly. There we go. Sorted. Now, the secondarily important task of paying off my enormous bounty. After the primarily important task of sorting out my neckwear. All right. Oh, Rhodes, you weirdly laid out. Confusing town. Woo! Take that, butcher.
Out of the way!
There's a bullet hole in my hat. Oh, today's been a disaster.
Hold on, I'll be right there.
Hey, mister!
Hey, I killed like 50 cops. I need to give you $165 for it.
Well, hello again.
I got another one. You
no, not really. I just want to pay my bounty, thanks. best I give it to you. And I'll have a train ticket to Saint Denis. Traveling style.
Okay, safe travels.
Oh. Philip Wilkinson says, I normally can't watch you stream during my workday, but virtual training, which means I can watch you live on my break. Keep up the great work. Oh, that's great. Thanks for joining, Philip. Hope you enjoy. Patrick Long says, you know that when you draw something, there's a light area between the object's shading and the shadow it casts. Ray tracing lets the game draw that. Yes. I still don't really understand. Luke T. Simmons says, hey, Andy, just finished meeting Mondays and arrived to the scene in The Rock where the tram chase is awful and brilliant. R.I.P. Sean Connery and Maguire. Indeed. Patrick Long says, this outfit is now sus in Saint Denis. You need a whole new wardrobe to avoid being made by police in future. I've paid off my bounty. I'm scot-free. Itzari says, like spike for bounty payoff. Yeah, why not? Let's have a like spike. I haven't even pressed like on this one yet. So join me in 3, 2, 1, like. Who's yelling at me? Look, I've got to see Charles Chatinet. Thank you very much for pressing the like button, by the way. It does help. I do appreciate it. Damn it, we're going to finish this mission on some light-hearted whimsy. If it kills me. Steedy. What are you doing on the other side of the train? Don't get hit by the train also. Ideally. You're just going to run alongside it forever. Alright. I'm going to have to do something. If I don't do something, CD is going to run out in front of this train and get killed, so...
Come on, girl.
You dumb horse with your pathfinding. Right. There we go. See? Police are fine with me now. I can probably go up to that cop and talk right to his face. Hey, cop. How's it going?
Evening, sir.
Officer.
Good evening, mister.
See you later.
Is someone there? Anything to say? Blind man.
Well, smart.
Don't you know how to control that thing? What's wrong with you?
Charles, buddy. What's going on? In some sort of romantic trouble, is it? Hey, it's enough out of you, menacing my friend Charles Chatinet.
Well, I don't know why I did that.
Because barbarity is boring, no?
It kept me amused some years.
You must go, my friend, before the gendarmerie arrive.
Hey, are you gonna do right by this fella's wife?
You have done right by her. The little bird is free. I am an artist, cowboy. I must do what
yes.
I feel. Look. I have an exhibit at the gallery. You come, see what I mean.
Sounds good. Let's go to the art exhibit. I'm excited. What is it now? Is it on now? Oh, man. Let's give him a kick for good measure. I might have to... What are you doing, game? I might have to sleep, I guess? For it to trigger, maybe? Can't go and do it straight away. That's fine.
Okay,
Well, skid. Yeah. All right. Quick, I need a room. I need to furiously sleep. Alright. After furiously sleep, get a solid, furious 12 hours. Mr. Maple Syrup says, was that entire mission just punching a dude once? Yep. I mean, they can't all be world beaters. All right, so we've got this one mission where you have to rob a trolley station and there'll be all sorts of explosions and chasing. And then the next mission, you have to punch a dude once. Furiously sleeping. Still no Charles Chatney, eh? If I sleep till night. Come on, Series X. Load quickly. Ah, boo. No Charles Chatney. We'll have to do it next time, I'm afraid. But we will do it next time. Next time is going to be a stream of entirely upbeat, light-hearted levity. It's going to be lovely. And we're not going to do the bank heist. We're just going to do nice things. It's going to be a nice, relaxing, fun time, like this was supposed to be, only ended up having to shoot like 10,000 people. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this Morgan Mondays. Thank you so much for sticking around and hanging out with me. Really appreciate it. We've got some cool stuff coming up this week. My Yakuza video will be going up tomorrow. It's about the weird sub stories in the game, which if you haven't seen, you really got to check it out. It's brilliant. It's extremely wild and funny. So yeah, I hope you'll check that out. And then on Wednesday, we'll be doing a cool Challenge of the Week stream. I think we're going to be hopefully finding out which of us is best at Tetris, because we've got the cool new Tetris on the Series X. So finally, we can settle that once and for all. And then I would like to play some more Phasmophobia this week. We'll see if that happens. Hopefully, maybe Friday. So stick around. Hope you have a great rest of your Monday. And I'll see you on the next Morgan Monday. Thanks for joining me, everyone. Bye.